Hello and welcome to Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning, and I'm in Arnold Ice Cave outside of Bend, Oregon. This is a lava tube cave, and if you follow the stream of molten lava up, you get to the Newberry Volcano, the largest volcano in Oregon. It's a basaltic shield volcano, which means it produces lava and eruptions a lot like the island of Hawaii. And when that sort of lava flows across the landscape in these huge flows, you end up with these huge lava tube tunnels, which I've talked about in other times on Better Geology. This is a very large one. It's called a feeder tube. In places, it's as much as 45 feet tall, 25 feet wide. It's a very large tunnel that would have been filled to the brim with lava at its time. However, this one is unique for the area in that it contains ice. Now, ice cave is a bit of a misnomer since an ice cave is a cave that exists in ice. So technically, it's a lava cave that contains ice. However, the fact that it contains ice is notable, and many ice caves around the West Coast contain a very important paleoclimate record. Gases and isotopes of water in these ices can give us a very good idea of what the climate has done and looked like over the past thousands of years. However, in this ice cave, there's very little ice remaining. If I was here 15 years ago, it would have been over my head, sealing the cave shut. But in 2010, the ice melted out almost completely, and now we can walk around and explore the cave. The reason these lava tube caves contain ice is because they generally have a very small opening. This small opening allows the cold air from these frigid winters that exist here to sink down into the cave and fill up the space with cold, frigid, moist air. That cold, moist air forms ice on the floor and on the walls, and over time, that is supposed to fill up the cave with ice. However, due to a changing and warming climate, ice is now harder and harder to form in caves due to shorter winters, warmer winters, and hotter summers. The small opening to this cave does continue to keep it quite chilly in here, and some ice is found. However, the amount of ice fluctuates greatly from year to year, and the last time I was here, there was no ice at all. The presence of ice in these caves does form an important paleoclimatic record. However, the changing climate that we live in now does hinder its existence and does remove this valuable resource of climate from the scientific annals forever. This has been Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning. Thank you for watching. Cool. One take. How's that?